Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Nideha madhyam sulabham sudurlabham plabham sukalpam gurukar nadharam Mayan kulena navasate ritam pumano na tareto bhavadim na tareto sa atmaha Nideha madhyam sulabham sudurlabham plabham sukalpam gurukar nadharam Mayan kulena navasate ritam Pumano bhavadim na tareto sa atmaha Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Gauriya Goshtipati told that who am I? This question should be discussed all the time. We are not going to discuss this point. That's why so many problems coming in front of us. Actually, all over the world there is one problem, single problem. There is one single problem that we cannot do actual bhajan. That is the only problem. No problem is there. Everything and all surrounding situation can get adjusted with you, provided you are ready to follow Sadguru and Vaishnava properly. The more you are adjusted with Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, be sure the more you are adjusted with pure Guru Vaishnava, you are automatically adjusted with Krishna. You need not play your head. Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupāda speaking, that who am I? Nobody wants to discuss this point. Lack of this discussion, we don't want to discuss this point. That's why so many problems coming in front of us. If we can understand who am I, we can speak. We can memorize. Maharaj, we know. Jive Swarupai Krishna Nityodas. Well, I know. Everybody can memorize and speak. But who can feel? Everybody can realize, but who can feel from heart? Feeling, where from you can get feeling? You can get everything out of your money power, manpower. But where from you can get feeling? Direct feeling. Direct feeling you cannot buy from market. Direct feeling only possible by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. Only by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava you can get direct feeling. And those jivatmas, those who are actually interested to cross over this material ocean, for them actually. Prabhupada speaking, those who are coming to me without any motive, without any actual motive, for them what I cannot do? Those who are coming to me without any actual motive, with some other motive, to get some position, money, rank, everything. Those who are coming to me without any appropriate actual motive, what I can do for them? They are not going to change their life. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, all our Guru Varga is one kind of milestone in front of us. But we never like to follow that milestone. So we cannot reach our destination. Jivatma, when entering into Jivatma, while traveling 14 world, Chaudha Bhuvan, traveling around, Brahmanda Brahmita Kano Bhagavanji, and according to their karma fal, previous activities, they can enter into any material body. Jivatma, Jivatma, where I can? Jivatma can enter into any material body according to the karma form. If the Jivatma going to enter into the body of elephant, then they can express that we are elephant. If that Jivatma going to enter into a woman body, I am woman. If Jivatma going to enter into any tiger, then tiger can say, I am tiger. This way, actually, big fallacy, one kind of magic spell of Maya. Maya cannot allow us to do actual bhajan. And the day when Krishna going away from this material world, the moment Krishna leave this material world, at the same time, Kali get entry. The moment Krishna leave this material world, Kali get entry. But up to Parikshit Maharaj, Kali couldn't show his great influence actually, up to Parikshit Maharaj. After that, he started doing all nonsense, rubbish. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Kamal Manjari, he crying and speaking in front of Jahnava Devi and speaking, writing one kirtan, Babar Nave Pore Mor Akulo Paran, this nice kirtan. We are not doing kirtan, that's why we are not getting kripa, power. We are not doing actual kirtan, harikatha, kirtan, all kirtan. We are not doing actual kirtan, that's why we are not getting power. Because to satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the only way, through Sankirtanaika Pitarau, you already know Sankirtanaika Pitarau Vrindavana Thakur, right? We have to satisfy Gauranga Mahaprabhu Sankirtan Pita through Sankirtan, but we are not ready to do Sankirtan. We think wastage of time, Maharaj. We think so. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur crying and speaking in Kirtan, oh Jahnava Maha, oh Jahnava Devi, Toma Charantari Koriya Asroy Bhavarnava Parabho Korichinishchoy. I have taken final decision to cross this material ocean with the help of your lotus feet. With the help of your lotus feet is one kind of boat, nice boat. With the help of your lotus feet, which is one kind of nice boat. Why nice boat? That boat can never meet with any accident. Material boat? Any time strong wind can come, you can go underwater. But why Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to take shelter of that boat? Charantari. Charantari mean, you know, Charantari mean lotus feet. Is one kind of, you know, boat. And that boat never going to meet with any accident. Because Nityananda Shakti Jahnava Devi is Ananga Manjari. Ananga Manjari, the youngest sister of Radharani. Krishna always satisfied with them. Radharani, Ananga Manjari, Lalita, Abhishaka, they are going to render the topmost seva for the entire satisfaction of Krishna. They are always busy doing seva. Only your seva mood, perfect seva mood can save you. Be careful. If you can memorize volumes of scripture, learn Sanskrit, but still there is no guarantee that you can cross this material ocean and climb the lotus feet of Krishna. Krishna charan kalpavitya kara arahan. Bhakti lata vijaya lito, the keeper grows. I can discuss this point all in details on Ekadashi day also. Two or three days I told you first discussion, then at a time we can publish. Not yet published. And also in the form of books we like to So actually, Bhakti Lata Beach we get, we take care of Bhakti Lata Beach, we put the seed inside, then we can get Kripa growing, sprout, then after Kripa growing, Kripa going, going, after that, you know, penetrate this Brahmando Kataha, Brahmando, Viraja, Brahmando Vedi, Viraja, Brahmando Vedi, after that, Brahmalok, Brahmaphausen, after that go, where? Vaikuntho, after that Chiddham, transcendental abode of Narayan, everything, then after that penetrate. From there also you go on taking care of Savan Kirtan. Well, why? Actually, to exchange, actually, five kind of rasa I can discuss on Ekadashi day. Why we are speaking this way? It's not good. Why you are speaking this way? Jive Sarubhai Krishna Nitodas. Why you are speaking this way? In Vrindavan there is so much fighting. Why? We are Ramdas. We cannot come out successful. You are speaking this way? Have some prejudicial idea? No, 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 not that. You are wrong. Jive Sarubhai Krishna Nitodas is an ideal term. Ideal term, Siddhanta. Why? Krishna is the original. That doesn't mean if you become Ramdas, you are actually useless. Not that. Krishna is original, so we use this word. This says Krishna Das. That means within Krishna Das, Ramdasya, Narayandasya, Nishingadasya, everything is there. We use this ideal term. That's why you are using. Not that. That Ramdas cannot come out successful. Who told you? Ramdas is the same, no problem. Only there is difference of rasa exchange. Only and only Jivatma can get topmost facility to exchange five kind of rasa with Krishna. Topmost. With other avatara, Ram, Nishinga, Varaho, you cannot exchange. Five kind of rasa, you cannot exchange. And on fullest exchange, you cannot exchange. We can come to this point is after. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur crying and speaking, they Toma Charon Tori Koriya Asroy Bhavar Nava Parhava Korichinishchvay. He Jannava Devi, I have taken strong decision to cross this material ocean with the help of your lotus feet, with your one kind of nice boat, like to cross. In Bhagavatam 11th canto, I started with one sloka, you can remember. You should remember this sloka. All the time, every fraction of second, you should get in touch with Guru Vaishnav and that Tattva, exclusive Tattva. Many times I told you can remember. If you can put one piece of iron bar, iron rod or bar inside glowing fire, gradually you can find that coal or that iron piece become red in color, molten gold. And when you take it out, after some time, it can again come back to its original color, black, blackness. Blackish color can develop. Coal or iron piece, so same. So what the procedure? The procedure is that you should get in touch with glowing fire, spiritual fire, glowing spiritual fire, like, you know, Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, exalted personality. Guru Vaishnava, pure. So, if you get in touch, mean get in touch with Guru Vaishnava all the time. Then you can show your nice color, molten gold, red. But as soon as you get detached from Guru Vaishnava, at least externally, at least externally, if you try, and internally you try, then also. And externally, if you are detached, if you are mentally attached, then still okay. Externally, at a bondage soul, if they are externally attached, mean they are externally attached, mean still it's okay. And they, if they are externally detached, it's big problem. Because internally they cannot, big problem. So actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that I like to cross this material ocean, similar way we like to speak from this 11th canto, this sloka, Nideham Adyam Sulabham, Sulabham Sukalabham Guru Karna Dharam. I told already. So actually, is written there in Bhagavatam, this material body is one kind of nice boat. This material body is one kind of nice boat with the help of which you can cross this material ocean, provided you can take shelter of a pure Vaishnava all the time. Nideham Adyam Sulabham Sudralabham Plavam Sukalpam Guru Karna Dharam. And in this boat you can find Gurudev or Vaishnava as the boatman who is going to guide you properly. Reckless driving is dangerous for you. Your reckless driving, you are always busy with reckless driving. There is no controlling. Fanciful attitude, fanatic mentality can drive you according to your material mind and according to the demand of your material sense organ. As and when your material sense organ demanding, hey, give me this, I like to eat something, you have to cook nicely. Today's chana rasa, puspanna, sweet bow, is demand of your tongue. Krishna only want to see your beautiful figure. Why we pray in front of Sudarshan? Rupa Manjari, at the time of Rupa Goswami Pada's appearance, we discussed, you know? Why? We like to get Rupa. Rupa means nice, beautiful attitude of our heart, not body. Maybe body is very beautiful. But those who are leather man, those who are actually leather man, they are very busy with body. Actually, Kesava Goswami Maharaj, you know, in one big mammoth gathering, he was speaking Harikatha in front of all big public in Calcutta. Sridhar Goswami Maharaj was there, president of that Sabha. And in the Sabha, when Kesava Goswami Maharaj started speaking, he said, first speech, in front of all those leather men, what I can speak? Harikatha. They all started shouting, big agitation started. Why? We are leather man. We are chamar. We are making shoe. Yes, you all are leather man. In front of leather man, what harikatha I can speak? Big agitation started. Big shava, hot situation. Then Sridhar Goswami Maharaj was very clever. He was actually big, you know, but he, lawyer, big. He was very clever. He took control over the situation. Immediately he took the mic. Wait, don't try to cite. We are very unhappy with this kind of remark. We like to get actual answer from this Maharaj. Otherwise we cannot allow him to go. Yes, you are right. Getting the support of all population to stop them barking. You wait. We like to get proper answer from him. Why he is speaking this kind of remark? It's not good. Chi. Then Sridhar Goswami Maharaj give the mic to him. He started speaking Harikatha so nicely. After Harikatha is over, or barking finish. Really, he is right. We are actually leather man. Really. We are actually leather man. our attitude, our activity, our motive, it can prove that we actually listen. We have nothing to speak with this big sadhu. Is right. Oh, problem stop. Follow. That's why in front of Rupa Goswami Pada, last moment Siddhar Goswami Maharaj singing this song. Prabhupada, when going away from this material world, giving order to Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Ramananda Prabhu, to sing this song. To sing this song, very nice. Rupa Manjari. Rupa Manjari. This song, very nice. So actually, we need to develop through our bhajan. We like to develop a beautiful figure. If Krishna is interested to see me, it's so beautiful. Beautiful mean? Not this body. Inside. Actually, Jivatma, I already told you, according to Sanskrit grammar, those who are actually having some degree in Sanskrit, they are not ready to accept. When I speak with, sometimes they have, I have chance, I speak actually, Jiva, they are actually Strilinga, but no Maharaj, why Strilinga? We can use Jiva Punglinga. Punglinga means masculine gender. But actually, Jiva Goswami Pada, Rupa Goswami, they use feminine gender. Because Jiva actually Tatasya Shakti, but they don't believe. They say according to grammar we can speak. Follow. They're using this. They are not ready. Actually, Jiva, they actually all feminine gender applicable. Like Shakti. Only when we use this word Jiva Purushaha. Jiva Purusha, when writing and speaking we speak, Jiva Purusha. That doesn't mean Jiva is that Purusha, Parameshwar. Follow? When we are writing Shastra, writing article, we use this term, Jiva Purusha. That doesn't mean that Purusha, Param Purusha. When we use this term Jiva Purusha, it means Jiva is Purusha. Why? But they have some enjoying mood. That's why we use this term. Purusha men have some enjoying mood. They want to get enjoyment. That's why we use this term. I already told you the explanation of this term Purusha. I already told you, na? Savai pungsam paro dharmo yato bhakti adhak radhak khaje Ahesuki apratihata jayatma su prasidati. Savai pumsam. As a purusha, pumsam means purusha. This purusha. Purusha is actually, we are calling by this name. It's called actually sambodhan purusha. First case, in case ending, first case, Purusha. Savai pungsam paro dharma. Is case ending changing? So, this Purusha, this term we use according to scripture, we can explain this way. This body is poor, this one kind of temple. This body is poor. There are nine gates there. Nine gates. I can show you. This body is one kind of temple. In this temple, Purusha, Param Purusha, Paramatma, Sri Krishna staying. That's why this body is one kind of temple. It's one kind of temple. And this temple, you can get nine gates. Through which, when you are going to die, your Atma can go out. So listen, any one of these nine gates, your Atma can go out. So here point is that, Pur means Purusha. This Pur means, Purusha means, Pure Dehe Basati Iti Purusha. Pure means, in this body, body is one kind of Pur. Pur means temple, we can say. Pur means one space, covered place where we can have safe journey. We can safe as pura. Pure, pure dehe basati iti purushaha. Jivatma, how we can explain? Pure mane this in this body, basati residing, that's why is purusha. Follow what I say? Pure means in this body, residing jivatma, that's why is purusha. And having some enjoying mood, that's why purusha. But actually param purusha means that parameshwar. Sometimes we can use this jiva purusha, we can use. Sometimes we say jivatma, sometimes we can say jiva purusha, we can use, no wrong. But why you use? Actually jivatma having some enjoying mood, that's why we use this one. So actually point is that in front of Krishna, in front of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, we always praying. We like to develop our nice figure, very beautiful figure. If Krishna is interested to see me, because Jivatma actually, Seva mood is called nice. Krishna like to see our Seva, excellent Seva mood. That is called our beauty, beautifulness. So actually, today is the appearance day of Srila Jagannamata Thakurani. And today is the appearance day of Ram Shakti Sita. Sita Devi, Shakti of Ramchandra Parameshwar. So actually, first we like to discuss this point. So Nideham Adhyam Sulavam Sukalpam Guru Karna Dharam, we have the facility to get our Gurudev as a boatman. So Gurudev can guide this boat, provided we are 100% inclined. Our whimsical attitude, our fanciful attitude cannot allow Gurudev to guide us properly. That is the problem. And who is not going to take this kind of chance? Who is not going to get avail? Those who are not going to avail this kind of chance, golden opportunity, they are actually committing suicide. It is written. Actually, they are going to commit suicide. They would be punished heavily. Those who are not going to cross this, take this opportunity, they are actually committing suicide. So this is a big problem. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur guiding us properly so that we can have strong belief unto the lotus feet of Nityananda. Unto the lotus feet of Nityananda mean Jagannamata Devi. Unto the lotus feet of Nityananda mean Jagannamata Devi. Because many time I told as per Vedanta Sutra, Shakti Shakti Mato Ravet. Shakti Man being the Supreme Lord, and Shakti, energy actually, potential already there inside. So it's one and a single tattva. So to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu is all the same when we say that we are going to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Jagannamata Thakurani. It's all the same. Actually, I like to touch some point regarding this tattva. So actually, Jagannamata Devi and Vasudha Mata Thakurani. Jagannamata Vasudha actually two sisters. Elder is Vasudha Mata Thakurani, Vasudha. And you know, small actually is Jagannamata Thakurani. Actually, father of Jagannamata Thakurani is Suryadas Sarkhel, Suryadas Pandit. Actually, the father of Jagannamata Thakurani is Suryadas Pandit, Suryadas Sarkhel. Actually, Suryadas, Gauridas, Krishnadas, there are so many, three or four brothers actually. So Gauridas Pandit, already you know, enjoying food. They actually Shakha of Krishna, there in Vrindavan, in actual Sarup. So you can find in Kalna, Ambika Kalna, you can go, not very near from Navadvip. There you can find the place of Gauridas Pandit, the same Vigraha with Gauranga Mahaprabhu approved. You install my Vigraha. I will have to go, na? You install my Vigraha in the form of Vigraha. No, I like to get you. This way Mahaprabhu proved that deity means I myself. That is why in Siddhanta it is written, Vigraha nau tumi shakshat brajandanandan. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, you are not deity. You are deity means you are Krishna yourself. Now I remember one nice joking, very nice. One day I heard it from Santu Goswami Maharaj. Some devotee is actually went to do some bhiksha. Bhiksha, you know, alarm, beg to different places. There was one very, you know, dangerous man. He said, "Hey, brahmachari, come. What? You need bhiksha? You do what you are doing? Wasting your life? No, no, we are not wasting. We are doing bhajan. You have seen Krishna? You have seen Krishna? You can show me Krishna?" That brahmachari was very puzzled. He was not smart enough to give answer. He couldn't give answer. "I can show you Krishna. I have seen Krishna." He cannot speak. That much belief we don't have. When he come back, in front of Gurudev speaking, "Today one very dangerous man putting this kind of question." Then Gurudev, "You are foolish number one. You are fool. Why? You not looking deity, Vigraha? Yes. Then why you don't say that I have not seen Krishna? That's obviously you don't believe Krishna and deity separate. Mayavadi." From then, he got some consciousness. Oh my God, really so? Vigraha nau tumi shakshat brajandanandan. That deity is Krishna himself. I couldn't give answer. This kind of problem. So actually, point is there. So Suryodas Pandit is got one title. His name is Suryodas Sarkhel. What do you mean by Sarkhel? Sarkhel means accountant. Accountant, not actually accountant. His title has some big inner meaning. Sarkhel means this Bengal government that time, the king of Bengal that time. Suryodas Sarkhel was a accountant. All different kind of expenditure done by king. He used to maintain everything properly, all the time. I mean, accountant book, all the time. Sarkhel, we like to solve all problem. You have to do this, this. You can give some investment here. You are wasting money there. This kind of, we're going to give advice. At the same time, maintaining all accounts of the king. Follow, Raja. That's why he was enjoying this title, Sarkhel. That time they used to live in, you know, Saligram village. One village was there, Saligram. They used to live. After that, they came in Kalna, Ambika Kalna, after. Actually, Jannabhadevi Thakurani and Vasudhamata Thakurani, actually, it is written that Suryodas Sarkhel is non-different from Revat Raja. Revat Raja, who took his daughter Revati up to Brahma to ask question. But that time Brahma was busy, some function was going on. So he couldn't get chance to ask some question in front of Brahma. So after function is over, Brahma asked, "What for you have come?" "Actually, I have come, some problem. I like to give away my daughter in marriage, but I cannot find any appropriate groom. Husband, I like to try. I like to take your opinion with whom I can give my daughter away in marriage. Brahma says, you are actually ill. Late actually. Late? Why? Because here in Brahma Loka, when you are watching this function, in the meantime, all in Shatta, Teta, all gone. Dapar already come, huh? Yes. Here time factor is different. Brahma says, you are full, you are late. When you go back, you cannot find a Shatta Yuga that Revat Raja is Shatta Yuga. He says, when you go back, you can find all men very small, small size. Because Satya Yuga gone, Teta Yuga gone. Why? But here time factor is different. Here time factor you watch. You watch your, you can watch your watch. 60 seconds, 1 minute. 60 minute, 1 hour. But there the time factor is totally different. Calculation. When function was over, in the meantime, Satya Teta gone. Dapar end almost. Yes, when you go back, you cannot find all relative, everything all gone. Then with whom I can? Now you can go back, you can find Balaji Maharaj there. I mean, who is Balav? Can go back. And give your daughter to him. That's right. Then that Revat Raja come back and arrange marriage of Revati with whom? Balaram. That Raja is, you know, Suryadas Pandit. Now, Revati Barani. Revati Barani. Two Shakti. Revati Barani is coming in the form of Shakti Amsa of Revati Barani is Janava Vasudha. Follow. Janava Vasudha. Revati is Jannavadvi, Barani is Barani, who? Vasudha Mata Thakurani. Actually, that actually Suryadas Pandit was busy with his actually service there. I already told he was maintaining accounts of, you know, the king of Bengal. After that, he took permission, came here. In Kalna, because already Gauridas Pandit was there, settled there, Kalna at the bank of Ganga, they used to, you know, do bhajan there. So there actually, one day, Suryadas Pandit is thinking, my two daughters, they grown up now, I will have to arrange a nice husband so that I can get satisfaction. But what to do? He is consulting with friends and everything. One day he is sleeping in dream. He saw Balaji Maharaj. Nityananda. So nice. Then after that he could realize my problem is solved. Some indication coming, you give your two daughters to Nityananda. Clear indication in dream. In the morning time, he discussing with Brahmin friends. This is very nice. You arrange. Then after immediately, Suryadas Pandit sending some messenger to Navadip Dham here in Mayapur, in Siva Sangan. Because that time, Nityananda Prabhu was there in Siva Sangan. When that messenger already declared the, you know, the desire of Suryadas Pandit. Then Sivas Pandit started dancing. And Nityananda came to know and smiling. Very nice. My Shakti coming to me. Material people, they are so idiot. They don't understand. Material people, they don't understand. They are fighting with this point. They fighting is all university scholar, idiot number one, they are getting doctorate degree. They are doing research on Gauranga and passing this kind of remark that Nimai Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was was in love with Vishnupriya. As well, a love affair was there with Vishnupriya. It was a love marriage. So our Guru Varga want to take out some sandal and throw on their face. On their face. We give answer to them. Idiot number one. This kind of, you know, not only that, even some so-called devotee is even speaking that Maharaj Nityananda got married with Janma Vasudha. So what wrong if I marry two times? I say, idiot, you get out from me. We are doing abra. Why Advaita Gosai doing two marriage, Nityananda? So I can also do guru. They are so material conception. Actually, this kind of kripa cannot touch them. That's why they are speaking this kind of... They forget that Lakshmipriya Vishnupriya is the eternal, you know, Shakti. Eternal potency, internal potency of Gauranga. They forget that Janma Vasudha is the eternal potency of Nityananda. They forget Mahavishnu avatar, Advaita Gosai, is, you know, Sita Thakurani and, I forget his name, I speak at the time of his appearance day, Sri. Sri Thakurani and Sita. They are two. Nishinga Bhaduri, two daughter. He was interested to give two daughters in the hand of Advaita Gosai because Advaita Gosai is Mahavishnu. Mahavishnu. So he is already selected. So Janma Vasudha got married with whom? With Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda approve it. Nityananda smile. Now after that the big arrangement was there for big function. Like you know, the total marriage ceremony, I mean the total expenditure was carried out by whom? Gauranga Mahaprabhu's marriage, who? Buddhimanta Khan. Here also another servant of some Krishnadas, his name. This Krishnadas is different, who is the brother of Suryodaya circle, is different. Another, he was a servant of Nityananda Prabhu. They arrange big, they are actually king of that place, big landlord. A total expenditure. Now we are very sorry to speak that big acharya, some big acharya. Big acharya mean they have some power, material power, nothing else. They wanted to prove that Nityananda is sannyasi, never we can approve that Nityananda already married. Nityananda never married. They wanted to write books. I was bound to give answer. So foolish. They say Nityananda was sannyasi. So how Nityananda can marry? They are speaking this kind of argument. I was bound to write one book, specially on this point. So this answer was there. So Nityananda, they think, they have some material conception. So they think this way. Actually Nityananda, taking sannyas, not taking sannyas, it matters little. Because Nityananda is topmost sannyasi. You know, I can prove Janma Mata is topmost sannyasi. I can prove Radharani is topmost sannyasi. But they cannot understand this Siddhanta. What do you mean by sannyasi? What do you mean by sannyasi? Sannyasi means shave your head, red cloth and one danda. You think this is your conception about sannyasi? You don't understand that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is topmost sannyasi. Though he was in grihastha, but still topmost sannyasi. Follow? You don't understand the meaning. The jivatma who is going to throw himself onto the lotus feet of Krishna without any condition, for all the time doing seva, he is actually topmost sannyasi. Mahaprabhu already told the meaning of sannyas. Already told, I many times told you, you forget. Paratma nishtha matro besh gohon. Mukundo sevai hai sangsat taron. Paratmanishthamatya Vesgohan, to exhibit my strong affinity, strong love for Krishna. That is the symptom of sannyas. Mahaprabhu speaking the explanation. I am not speaking. Paratma nishthamatto bejgrohon. Why I have taken sannyas? To prove that to show my excellent submission unto the lotus feet of Krishna, to show, to do 100% seva all the time. That is the mode of sannyas. Follow. Mahaprabhu speaking, paratma nishthamatro bejgrohon, mukunda sevai hai sangsattaran. When we can do mukunda seva under the guidance of Guru Vishnu, that is the final thing. Because that life is final. Then we can cross over this material ocean and go reach the lotus feet of Krishna. Even Mahaprabhu was bound to speak after sannyas. Mahaprabhu was just like sweet madness. Mahaprabhu was expressing sweet madness, sweet madness. That time Mahaprabhu was bound to speak. Mahaprabhu speaking. Ki kaj sannyase mor prem nijodhan. Prem, love, prem is my own property. Why I have taken sannyas? Mahaprabhu was bound to speak. After taking sannyas, Mahaprabhu was crying and spinning in front of devotees. Ki kaj sannyase mor prem apan dhan. Why? Why? They are taking sannyas to reach the ultimate goal of Krishna Prema. Follow what I say. What is the ultimate goal of sannyas? To get Krishna Prema. But if he is not, if any jivatma not going to get that kind of facility, I mean opportunity, then what use of sannyas? Only bank balance, billions of dollars in bank, some danda and worship me, give me garland, this much, nothing else. Follow. Tinadabhi, they can never prove that they are Tinadabhi. They can never prove that Tinadabhi. Tinadabhi means already everything is there. Everything. Sannyas brata is already there. Tinadabhi, if you can prove that you are Tinadabhi, then you are sannyas inside. When I can discuss Gita, I can prove. But Krishna wants to speak in front of Arjuna. I can prove. No, sannyas means you already going to submit yourself fully unto the lotus feet of Krishna. You are going to get punishment by this danda. Danda mean? Danda mean punishment. Danda in Sanskrit, in Bengali, I can give you danda. Dodichura Mahasavi, no? Nityananda give punishment to Raghunath Das Goswami, this is a danda. A danda, this mean is danda. Danda not, doesn't mean only strict. You think danda means one stick. Danda means punishment. Punishment, what kind of punishment? Kai man bakya. By body, mind and speech. You are going to give full punishment. You are going to put total embargo on yourself. Hey, be careful all the time. Don't speak bad. Don't hear bad. Don't do bad. Don't look bad. This kind of embargo. All the time. Restriction. It's called danda. Kai man bakya. Tidanda. What do you mean by tidanda mean? Tidanda sannyas mean three danda there. Three danda. Tin danda. Tin danda mean kai, you have to give punishment to your body so that your body is always in line with Krishna seva. Danda. One punishment. You are giving punishment to your body. You are not going to enjoy. Like all material people, enjoying all the time. This body punishment. Speech, don't speak bad. All the time you will have to speak about Krishna or related thing. Devotee, follow. Speech. Kai, Bakka and Man mean mind. Your mind should always think about Krishna. In your mind, if somebody is sannyas, actual sannyas, you cannot find any space inside his mind where you can put some material thing. Follow? A perfect sannyasi, his mind is so captured by Krishna Baba, You cannot find even a small space where you can put some matter inside there. Whole mind and body is called sannyas. So Vishnu Piyadevi is topmost sannyas. Janava Mata Thakurani is a topmost sannyas. Radharani is topmost sannyas. But externally you cannot see. Really so. Janavadharani whole life I can prove. I can prove Janavadharani whole life doing the duty of a topmost acharya. Even more than Nityananda. Nityananda was actually avadhut, sometimes acting some like mad. But Janavadharani acting as acharya, topmost acharya in the world. Same thing, I mean, but still, more than Nityananda. Whole life, Janavadharani acting as big acharya. If you look at Janavadharani, you can shake your head. I can prove one by one. Even Jiva Goswami Pad, when come in front of, you know, Janavadharani, prostrated officers. Because they know Siddhanta. Nityananda is all the same with Janava Thakurani. Follow. This way, now Revati Varani came in the form of Janava Vasudha Thakurani. So in dream when they saw, Vasudha arranged marriage, already I told, big arrangement, somebody, some big acharya thinks that they are speaking all rubbish Siddhanta. They say Nityananda, how Nityananda can marriage? Nityananda was sannyas. But I already proved in that book small, but we have no chance to translate. We need 100 people. We need 100 people all the time, day and night to translate before my death. When I can die, I don't know. But I have no scope. Oh, alone, running here, there, do this, that. Ooh. So then you can understand. Follow. There it is written actually, that Nityananda actually, when Nityananda is avadhut sannyas, avadhut sannyas, what is the condition of avadhut sannyas? I already told, sannyas is there all the time. Because Nityananda is the topmost servant of Gauranga. Topmost servant. Gauranga Mahaprabhu himself speaking. Whatever I think inside my mind, instant you do it in applied form. You show it. Gauranga Mahaprabhu many times told. Whatever I am thinking, you do in applied form. Say you are topmost. Follow, you see. Nityananda is avadhut sannyas. So you are going to find fault with him. You go through Chaitanya Bhagavat. I know you are not going through Chaitanya Bhagavat. Why? I can give you punishment, heavy punishment. You can find Nityananda here in Nandanajaja Bhavan with full ornament, diamond, everything, full, like Balaram. Some dacoit came. They even look inside, oh my God, full ornament, everything. When the some devotee, so-called devotee, putting some complaint in form of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Hey, he's sannyasi, putting so much ornament, this, that, crown, jewel, everything. Gauranga Mahaprabhu laughing, foolish. It's not ornament. In the form of ornament, Navavida Bhakti, ninefold of Bhakti is there. You find it ornament, idiot number one. It's not ornament. In the form of ornament, oh, you know, different kind of ornament is Navavida, ninefold of Bhakti. In the form of ornament you find. Gauranga Mahaprabhu told, if Nityananda going to accept one Muslim lady, still we all can give salute and dandava. Yes, Gauranga Mahaprabhu told. Because any kind of sinful activity cannot touch Nityananda. He is the source of all piousness. He is the source of all sukriti. He is the source of all bhakti. Source. Gauranga Mahaprabhu repeatedly told in Chaitanya Bhagavat. Chaitanya said, you go, you read You try to read Jaiva Dharma. You should try to read Chaitanya Sikshamrita. You try to read Dasamal Tatha. You try to read Mahaprabhu Shiksha. You try to go through Manasiksha. But you are not ready to follow me. You like to jump and go to Ujjal Nilmani to become a gopi. How you can become gopi? I don't know. How you can become gopi if you cannot follow Guru Varga? I don't know. It's not possible. Bhaktivinoda Thakur repeatedly told. So now point is that actually Krishna Bhagavan in front of Buddha already told what is the symptom of avadhut sannyas. Externally you cannot find danda, you cannot find color, red color of cloth. Sometimes you can find full naked. Gaur Kishore Baba, sometimes without any cloth. But you can find some problem with him. Follow? Krishna Bhagavan speaking. Jnananishto virakto va madbhakto va anapekshakaha salinganam asram stakta charit abhidhi gocharah. Jnananishto virakto va madbhakto va anapekshakaha salinganam asramam stakta charit avidhi gochara. They are beyond any rules. They are beyond any rules. You cannot put any kind of rules and regulation on them. If you like to put some rules and regulation of on Gaur Kishore Baba, you are foolish. They are beyond any rules and regulation. Paramahansa. So Paramahansa actually is you cannot explain the character of Paramahansa. Jnananishto virakto va madbhakto va anapekshaka salinganam asramam stakta charit avidhi gochara. They are beyond any ashram and varna ashram or symptom of any external bhajan like sannyas, brahmacharya. No, you cannot find anything. You cannot find. Actually, Gauranga Mahaprabhu himself giving strict advice to Nityananda to take sannyas. In Purushottam, nobody knowing they are fighting, but nothing written about it. How you can find written? How you can find? Everything is not there in written. So how you know? How you know that Sarup Gosai is the topmost leader of whole controller of Gauriya Vaishnava Samaj? Where it is written? You show me where it is written. Can you show me? Where it is written that Sarup Gosai was made the topmost leader, controller of whole Guru Gauriya Vaishnava Samaj? Who make him? Under the guidance of Sadguru Vaishnava Prabhupada Bhakti, we can come to know that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself gave instruction to Sarup Gosai. I already explained at the time of Gundicha Manjan Day. You can go through Harikatha. They already explained that Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving instruction. Through some speech, Tomar Gauriya Kare Atek Phoyati. Your Gauriya making so problem, see. I mean, all Gauriya, it is your responsibility to get control over all Gauriya Vaishnava Samaj. That time, Mahaprabhu giving indication to Sarup Gosai. All and everybody bound to obey you. This was strict instruction. Sarup Gosai is the topmost controller of all Gauriya Vaishnava Samaj. Nobody knowing where it is written. Where it is written that Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving instruction to Nityananda. First logic, Nityananda Prabhu cannot do anything which is not in favor of Gauranga. First point, you are bound to obey. Because it is written, Nityananda always going to fulfill the desire of Gauranga. It is written, Chaitanya Bhagavacharya, everywhere. It is the only duty. It is the only duty of Nityananda Prabhu to implement the desire of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Then how you can say that Nityananda Prabhu going to marriage out of his own desire? Not even one action you cannot prove. So Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving instruction to Nityananda, anyway he is not Tridanda Sannyas. He is Avadhut. Avadhut naturally Sannyas. Advaita Gosai also Sannyas. All the time. Their attitude, activities can prove they are topmost sannyas in the world, infinity universe. In this way, actually, top secret Siddhanta, that Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving instruction to Nityananda to marriage and preach extensively. Anyway, Nityananda, in front, Nityananda is Balaram. In front of Nityananda is internal potency. Vasudha Jannava is supposed to come. Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And another point, one sannyas cannot reach each and every place. One grihastha, if he is topmost, he's a big devotee, and grihastha can get chance to serve, Prabhu very nicely, together with wife. At the same time, sannyasi cannot reach everywhere. Suppose I am sannyasi, I cannot reach family, any house, any time, without any permission, without any restriction, I cannot go. But any grihastha devotee can reach there. So for extensive preaching, Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving instruction to Nityananda, do extensive preaching. What is not possible for me? Gauranga Mahaprabhu speaking openly. What is not possible for me? What is not possible for me, that is possible for you. You go through Chaitanya Bhagavata. I am speaking now, it is recorded. You can prove what I am speaking. What is not possible for me, it is possible for you. So you go to Bengal, and start preaching. Nityananda Prabhu, doing extensive preaching. And Jannava Thakurani actually acting as Acharya. Especially after Nityananda gone. And after that actually, Vasudha Mata Thakurani got one daughter, Gangama. Gangama is not Gangamata Thakurani. It's different. Ganga. His name Ganga, daughter. And another son, his name is Birchandra. Birchandra is the son of Nityananda. You should not have any material conception, like material father and mother. No. Nityananda. Nityananda is Sakshat Balaram. So Nityananda, the son of Nityananda is Nityanandatmajo is Birbhadra, Birchandra. And one daughter, Ganga, this way. Birchandra, they have some place there in Khordha, in Calcutta. From Barakpur, it is not so Barakpur, when you are going to Calcutta through local train or any train, you can find one station, Barakpur. Near Barakpur is Khordha, one place, at the bank of Ganga, where you can go and find, still today, you can find. Dadi Chira Matsav, Chira and Dadi. Dadi card. This big Utsav was there at the bank of Panihati. It's near Khordha. Khordha and Panihati are almost adjacent. Panihati, that Utsav was there in Panihati, where Raghunath Goswami wanted to take full kripa from Nityananda. In Panihati, through Nityananda. Follow. And that Khordha is just next station. In Khordha, you can find the house of Nityananda Prabhu, Bhajan, everything. They used to live. And Jannava Matarani, all the way, she was busy with all devotees, all the time, doing kripa. Follow, you see, all the time. Jannamatara is always busy. So, actually, especially after Nityananda gone, Jannamatara Thakurani acts as topmost acharya all the time. Follow, you see. So, Jannamatara Thakurani went to Keturi, Keturi one place in Rajshahi, Bangladesh, at present Bangladesh, it is not actually Bangladesh. Actually, it is India, Bharat. It was within India that time. It's very near from Calcutta. But it's very near from Calcutta. Only 3-4 hours from Calcutta. You can reach Keturi. Keturi, there was big Utsav. In Kethuri, there was big utsav, big utsav. Evergreen utsav. Never in the history of Vaishnava society. They cannot find that kind of big utsav. Eh? Santosh Datta, the father of? Narottama Thakur. Big king of that place. There is big temple. Six deities were installed. Six deities were installed there at the time. That big function, that time, Nithananda Sakti, Jahnava Mata Thakurani, was invited. And that time, actually, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya was there. Vrindavan Das Thakur was there in team, and that team, when Jahnava Mata Thakur was going, na? That team. When? And that team, Krishna Das, the uncle, I already showed that Krishna Das, one uncle, Gauri Das, Krishna Das, Sujyoda, uncle of, Jahnava Mata Thakurani, was there at that team. Parameshwari Das, Achyutananda, they are full troops going to participate there in function. They are in Kethuri, big function. We can never see this kind of function. No bhutam, no bhavishyati. Previously we never see, and in future we can. Thousands of devotees from different parts of from Vrindavan, Puri, here, they all are reaching. That big function, big arrangement was there. There are actually six deities. Six deities were installed there. One deity, already they find from the inside of paddy godown. Paddy, you know, in village you can find some unstable paddy godown. They put paddy, and it is round, with bamboo structure and this leaf and that. Then Narottama Thakur, in dream that deity came. When Nithyananda Prabhu opened, they find big snack here. After that, through kirtan, that snack gone, that deity coming out from that go down. After that, six deity were installed there at a time. So, big arrangement there.
Which deity was in the paddy?
Well, that deity, I forget the name actually. I cannot remember. Six name, different name, I forget the name. I remember, but I forget that present. There in Radha Brajamohan, like that.
Two, Radha Krishna deity.
Yes, at a time, from that go down. So, this way actually, that big function. And Jahnava Mata Thakurani give instruction to Narottama Thakur to start kirtan. And Srinivasacharya. Samananda Prabhu, Srinivasacharya, Ramchandra, everybody going there. And it was the responsibility of Srinivasacharya to do Abhishek. Abhishek was done by Srinivasacharya. Abhishek, you know, deity Abhishek was done by Srinivasacharya. And kirtan started by Narottama Thakur. Special kirtan. When kirtan going on, all the surrounding situation took a nice, you know, environment, like we are in Goloka. They all feeling we are in Goloka. When kirtan going on, everybody sharing, they are doing enthusiastic kirtan and dancing. And they all could see Gaur Nithyananda already appear in this kirtan. They are also dancing. Gaur Nithyananda appear in that kirtan. When Narottama Thakur dance, doing kirtan, all devotees dancing and doing kirtan, they find Gaur Nithyananda also doing kirtan in Sava. Appear. Oh, miracle.
But they had already left the planet.
Gaur Nithyananda has already left at that time.
But they appear in kirtan.
Not feel. Physically they find.
Physically.
Physically they find Gaur Nithyananda doing dancing. After that, I say, Janamata Rarini Thakurani, Janamata Thakurani took responsibility to cook for Radha, Brajamohan, Radha, so many names. Radha, Bhojanath, so many names. I forget. Janamata Thakurani herself started cooking. Very nice cooking. For Boga. Janamata Thakurani herself. So, Janamata cooking for, they took prasadam, so nice, big utsav. Then on and on, Janamata Thakurani, when Nityananda gone already, then after that, see, acting as Acharya, big Acharya. Sometime going to Vrindavan, sometime going here, there. I'm not going to speak in details, but time cannot permit. Because also I have to touch the, glory of Sita Devi. So time cannot permit. So that time actually, Janamata Thakurani started from Vrindavan, full group, full troops. Then when Janamata Thakurani reaching Mathura, then Jiva Goswami Path, Madhu Pandit or big Gaur Parshad, they took information that Janamata Thakurani coming. They all coming with everything to provide them wide acclamation. I know. They actually, they meet Pe Dandabad. After they Janamata Thakurani taking darshan, actually, Ananga Manjari, but still I am speaking this way, what to speak? Took darshan of Radha Govindo, Radha Gopinath, Radha Madanma. Because that time, all deities were there. After that, situation could not permit all deities to stay there. Even you know already, Vrindadevi deity. Huh? That Vrindadevi deity came in dream of king. Don't take me out of Vrindavan. But they like to take out of Vrindavan because Muslim people like to attack. That's why Govindadev was taken up to Jaipur, interior place. You will have to walk some 2 or 3, 4 kilometers inside. Then you can find Govinda Mandir. Why? If you go to Gopinath, from the main road you have to go inside. Then you can find. Why? Because Muslim people are going to attack Gopinath. Madan Mohan. Karoli, Madan Mohan. Govinda Gopinath in Jaipur. And Radha Madhav in Jaipur, the deity worshipped by, Jayadev Goswami. Or Radha Damodar. All there. And Sinadji. Govardhan Dari, Sinaji, already taken up to Gujarat. Gujarat, you know? Eh? Nathodwar, Gujarat. By Vitthal Nath, the son of Ballavacharya. By Vitthal Nath, the son of Ballavacharya was taken there because of Muslim atrocity. The bound to take. But Vrindadevi is speaking, don't take me out of Vrindavan. I like to stay here and Kamban. So you can find that Vrindadevi is still today in Kamban. You can go. Same Vrindadevi. You can find in Kamban there. So this way actually, Janamata Thakurani went there, Ananga Manjari, and taking darshan of Govinda, Gopinath, Madan Mohan, Radha Damodar, they are taking darshan. All full. Brajadham. And in different place of Brajadham, different place of Brajadham mean different Nila Khetra of Krishna. Janamata Thakurani expressing different kind of mood, ecstatic love, sometimes crying, sometimes rolling down on ground, ecstatic feeling. This way. And Janamata Thakurani was very happy to see the situation in Vrindavan. All big Acharya. Big. Jiva Goswami Path are all. They are coming. Madhu Pandit, they came. Vedandavad. This way actually, Janamata Thakurani ultimately went to Ekchakra Dham also. Janamata Thakurani went to Ekchakra Dham. To take darshan of Ekchakra Dham. There when Janmatharagiri went, that time Harai Pandit, Padmavati Ma already leave this material world. Only some ruin, but no building all, you know, Bhajan Kuji all broken, Nityananda birthplace. Yeah, there is written when Janmatharagiri went to take darshan of that birthplace of Nityananda, then Janmatharagiri couldn't resist, couldn't check herself, crying and crying, rolling down on ground, and crying in the name of Harai Pandit and Padmavati Ma. So nice. Ek Chakradham. After that came back here. Also, in different place, sometime coming to Navadip, sometime going to here and there, Janmatharagiri Thakurani. Also, you know, Janmatharagiri Thakurani, by the mercy of Janmatharagiri Thakurani, we can get Janmatharagiri Thakurani bring Krishna Balaram from Vrindavan, one deity, Krishna Balaram. That deity you can find in the next station of Kalna. Next station is Guptipara. Guptipara, one place. Just next station of Kalna, you can find a deity, Krishna Balaram. Follow, you see. This way actually, whole life, Janmatharagiri Thakurani acting as Acharya, thousands of people, thousands of Jivatma, they all received kippa of Janmatharagiri, even more than Nityananda. Nityananda Prabhu, they got kippa. They all got kippa, full kippa, that is. You can find the Bhajan Kutir of Janmatharagiri Thakurani at the bank of Radha Kunda. You been there? No? No? At the bank of Radha Kunda, there is one small space. Every time when I go, I pay dandavat. All the time. When I do, all the time. You can find Bhajan Kutir. There, Janmatharagiri Thakurani deity is there. He is doing bhajan all the time. Very nice. So, without the kippa of Janmatharagiri Thakurani, we cannot feel topmost tattva. We cannot feel. Because already our Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda giving indication, Tomacharantari Koriya Asroy, Bhavarnava Paravukari Chinishroy. We have taken decision, final decision to cross this material ocean, by the mercy of your lotus feet, is one kind of boat, nice boat. So all, you know, Jivatma is one kind of boat. They are floating in this infinity world. You can get lost, come on. If you are going to do any mistake, aparadh, big aparadh, in that case, you can get lost in this infinity world. Because Jivatma, infinity. You can say, Maharaj, all Jivatma, so countless Jivatma, where they can get space, you are foolish. The arrangement of Krishna is infinity. Arrangement of Krishna is infinity. So all Jivatma, infinity, no problem. So now I am coming to discuss something about Sita Devi, Shakti of Sri Ramchandra. Ramchandra. Follow. Non-different from Ramji. Actually, Mithila, one nice place. At the time of Gauranga Mahaprabhu Advaita Gosai, Sarvam Bhattacharya, Mithila was the topmost place of logic, Tharka, Blas, Nyaya Shastra. After that, actually, this Navadvipa also, topmost place of, but there also, big. Follow what I say. Sarvam Bhattacharya gone there. Sarvam Bhattacharya went there. His name was not Sarvam Bhattacharya first. Vasudev Bhattacharya. Vasudev Sarvam. His actual name is Vasudev Sarvam, went there. That place is actually at the just border of Nepal. that Mithila is a bank of, as just as a border of Nepal. Nepal, that place is very nice place, hilly place, very nice. You can go to Nepal very, from Roxol, one place in Bihar you will have to go, or from Patna also go, it's more, you know, problem, big distance. From Roxol, it's near. Roxol, one place, and Bihar. From there you can go to Mithila, one place. Mithila is a place where language is Maithili language, Maithili. Very sweet language, Maithili language. Jayadev, Vidyapati is a Maithili kovi. He is originally from, Vidyapati is originally from that place, Mithila. Follow? And our Advaita Goswami meet this, you know, Jayadev, Vidyapati, there. I already told. So there actually, Mithila Raj, the king of Mithila is, Who is the king of Mithila? Janaki? Janak Raja. Janaki, daughter name. And Janak Raja? Janak Raja, be careful, Janak Raja is 12 out of 12, one Mahajan. Janak Raja was topmost, you know, sannyasi. But he was like externally he was king. Externally he was king. But that Janak Raja was topmost sannyasi. External, internally. Janak Raja was topmost, you know, tattva-jnani. That's why our Vyasadeva Goswami took trouble to send his son Sukadeva to him to get approval. Otherwise people can say, topmost tattva, you are going to teach your son. Topmost tattva, you are going to give to your own son. Topmost tattva, they are going to your own son. That's why big problem. So, Vyasadeva Goswami took decision to send Sukadeva to Janak Raja for approval, to get some certificate. If Janak Maharaj is thinking he is the fittest person to whom you can give Bhagavad Rasa, only for this reason. And Sukadev Goswami was approved by Janak Maharaj. Follow? Sukadev Goswami, purposely, Vyasadeva Goswami took decision to send him.
But Sukadev Goswami appeared in Kali Yuga, prior to Kali Yuga.
No, actually.
He appeared prior to Kali Yuga.
No, actually, it is written there that Raja, king is there for long. In Bhagavata, you can find, in Teta Yuga, you can find Janak Maharaj. It is written there. Actually in Sarup. In actual Sarup, they are eternal. In this way you can think. So actually, so Leela can come up and down, that's eternal. So this way actually, Bhagavad is also eternal. So this way actually, Sukadeva Goswami is up. That Janak Maharaja. You know, Dadas Mahajan, you know. Prahlad Vismo Janako Bolir Vaya Sakirabhayamzu Prahlad Vismo Janako. Janak Maharaja already coming. So Janak Maharaj. No. Janak Maharaj already coming. So Janak Maharaj, you see, is the king of Mithila, and Sita Devi is the daughter of Janak Maharaj. So Sita Devi was giving marriage with some big history, I don't like, big, you have to speak. Someday actually, Muni, his name is? Vishwamitra Muni. Vishwamitra Muni took Ram Lakshan with him and reached Mithila. In Mithila garden, they are waiting. There actually Ramchandra saw Sita Devi first time. Nitya Shakti actually. And by system actually that time marriage was arranged. And after that actually Sita Devi took resolution to serve Ramchandra totally. Even when Ramchandra was sent to exile, that time Sita Devi told, I must go. Took trouble. Oh, whole life. Even the speciality is that actually Sita Devi wanted to serve Ramchandra all the time. Every time. And some, you can put some question by, if Sita Devi is actually, if Sita Devi is Shakti of Ramchandra, why Sita Devi was asking Ramchandra to go in behind of that Harin, deer? It's not good. There is no ignorance we can expect with Sita Devi. This is one kind of Leela, actually. This is one kind of Leela. Actually, it is not possible for Sita Devi to request Ramchandra to go behind, you know, it's one Rakshas, Marich. That Rakshas, the name of that Rakshas was Marich. Marich came in the form of a deer, golden deer. So Sita Devi requesting Ramchandra, you can go and catch for me. She said, no, it's not actually, there's a different kind of, you know, magic, you see, is all Rakshas are staying here. No, you will have to go and catch. It's one kind of Leela, nothing else. And at the same time, it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita also, Mahaprabhu giving evidence, that when Ravana came to arrest whom? Sita Devi, at the same time, I've been there, just 2 years before, there, Dandakaranya. The place where Sita Devi was abducted by Ravana, that place is Andhra, is one Andhra, MP and Andhra border is Andhra, is actually Andhra, almost border. I've been there, MP and I border there at the bank of Godavari Nadi is also there. They actually, when Ravana came, that time Sita Devi. When Ravan catch Sita Devi, then it is written that in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Kurma Puran, you can get one evidence that actually that was not Sita. It was a shadow of Sita. It is not actual Sita. As and when Ravan came to arrest Sita, Sita Devi disappeared. And shadow of Sita came. Shadow means, you can think, my shadow, how? Your shadow is different. But their shadow is same, almost same. You can think something wrong. Well, shadow, how is possible? Shadow. But still, shadow means, it's like Sita, totally. That time, Sita Devi disappear, taking shelter to Agni Deva, and shadow came, and Ravan thought that I am going to arrest Sita Devi. It is written. Actually, Chit Shakti, internal potency of Ramchandra. How it is possible for Ravana or Rakshas to arrest, to touch Sita Devi? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how it is possible? It is the internal potency of Ramchandra. How Ravana can touch? How Ravana can see? What to speak about touching? Even Ramchandra cannot see Sita Devi. This kind of Siddhanta from Kurma Puran, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is showing us. So we have document in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So one, I like to speak some vital thing because time cannot permit. Sita Devi whole the whole life, we can see, she was Pativrata Nari. Pativrata mean one. One and non-different from Sami, husband. But still, in the life of, you know, in the Leela of Ramchandra, we can see that Ramchandra going to establish idealism. Ramchandra going to establish idealism. Adarsha Purushottam, Leela Adarsha. And Krishna is Leela Purushottam. There. So, Such thing happened, actually Sita was abducted by Ravan. So different kind of Leela took place. You already know. Ravan and Kumbhakarna who? Ravan Kumbhakarna who? You already know. You already know. Who? Hiranyakasipu and Jai Vijay? Hiranyakasipu and Hiranyaksha. After that, Ravan Kumbhakarna, Shishupal Dantavarka. This way you already know. They actually this way actually. So actually there Sita Devi was abducted. Thus when Sita Devi was there in one garden, it's called actually Nandankanan. What the name of that? Nandankanan. There. Ravan. There actually. That time when Ramchandra and Lakshman, all full troops went and killed Ravan, that time Sita was taken back. But finally, Ramchandra wanted to arrange one testing for Sita. Because otherwise people can say, Sita was abducted by Ravan, Rakshas. We have some doubt about her chastity. We have some doubt about her chastity. Then Sita Devi wanted to give ready. I can give evidence. That time, glowing fire, Sita Devi entered into fire. Fire cannot touch Sita. Glowing fire, big fire. That time Sita Devi entering into fire. All people watching. Fire cannot do any harm, fire not touching. Then it is the evidence that Sita Devi can prove her chastity. Even after that, sometime it happens so, Ramchandra sometime used to go outside in civil dress. Civil dress, you know? Civil dress. It was the usual practice of king that time. Like Prahlad Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj. Now at present all kings are their demon. That time it was usual practice. The king usually, without informing anybody, with civil dress, no crown, nothing. Civil dress, they are going running here and there to know the grievance of public. If at all any grievance is there, public grievance, you know. They used to go outside. Yudhishthira Maharaj also. Without any civil dress, going outside, watching here and there to see if there is any grievance, if there is any problem. Follow. At that time, one day, Ramchandra going through one place, in one house there is big fighting between husband and wife. Big fighting, altercation, speaking all rubbish to each other. Ramchandra, what happens? Wait, for 1 second he is waiting. Oh my God, Ramchandra was shocked. The husband saying, I am not coward like Ramchandra, so that Sita going there in Lanka, staying with Ravan, and Sita was taken back by Ramchandra. I am not so coward. I cannot take you back in my home. Go outside. Ramchandra, oh my God. People, they have some wrong conception about me. Oh my God. Then Ramchandra came back and took decision and giving order, took decision to send Sita Devi to exile. Took decision to send Sita Devi to exile. Lakshmana was given responsibility. Lakshman, you take Sita Devi and go to exile there. Oh my God. Sita Devi was there. In exile, there, follow. And there, she gave birth to two twine boy, one Lava Kusha. Lava and Kusha, this, there. Lava Kusha is same powerful like Ram Lakshan. When Ashwamedh Yoga was there, it was a usual practice, it is a system, that your horse, those powerful horse, you'll have to put some banner here, and you can leave that horse, can go anywhere. If somebody is going to catch that horse, then he will have to fight with the king. Follow? Horse can run here and there. And that horse was caught by Lavakusha, small boy. Ramchandra got information. Who? But some small two boys. They catch God. What? They send Lakshman, go and check up the situation there. He is so small boys. Speaking boldly in front of Lakshman. Now after that with Lakshman, big fighting. Oh my God, so powerful, small boy. After that, Lakshman could come to know, oh, it's my nephew. Oh, Lakshman. This way, after that, Sita Devi actually was bound to go to exile. Ultimately, when again Sita Devi was bound to prove her chastity, after that is then Ravan, that the land crack, prithivi crack, and Sita Devi going down. Ramchandra watching that land crack and Sita Devi going down. Then Ramchandra crying, Sita, Sita, Sita crying. But when reach that spot, Sita already gone outside. Ramchandra was so heavy feeling, because Ramchandra from heart knowing, because Nitya Shakti, Sita Devi. After that, Ramchandra, when he is going to arrange big jagya. In jagya, it is the usual practice, you will have to take your wife with you. But wife gone? Sita Devi already gone? Sita Devi already gone. Then Ramchandra used to make golden Sita every time. As and when Ramchandra used to arrange jagya, because Teta Yuga is a special thing. Follow? Teta Yuga. That time Ramchandra used to make golden Sita and installed, and with Sita and left, used to do jagya. After jagya is over, all Sita, deity of all Sita, used to put in one godown. After that, there all Sita, you know, deity. They all took birth in Mathura, I mean Vrindavan, to get full kripa of Ramchandra. Follow? All deity in store? You can think one deity is sufficient, Maharaj, but Ramchandra used to install deity, Sita, every time. All deity installed means all Sita. If from Sita, Sita coming, Sita is left. Don't think, Maharaj, one Sita gone from Sita, wow, Sita can left. You have some finite conception. From Sita, Sita coming means Sita left. So, don't think otherwise. So, it is written in Garga Sankhita or everywhere, some place you can find information. Those deities of Sita, they took birth as gopi in Vrindavan to take part in the Leela of Krishna, Leela Purushottama. Follow? This way actually, Sita Devi, if you go in details, you can find some detailed information. But in Bhagavatam also some information there, not so details, but in Tulsidasi Raman. Raman was compiled by Valmiki Muni. Before Ramchandra came, 60,000 years before Ramchandra came, Ramayana was compiled. How possible? You can see everything. Valmiki Muni. Follow? That Valmiki Muni, it is written there, that Valmiki Muni came in the form of Tulsidas. Tulsidas. Tulsidas compiling Ramayana in a very sweet way. Valmiki Ramayana is the original Ramayana. From that, on the basis of that Valmiki Ramayana, on the basis of that Valmiki Ramayana, that Tulsidasi Ramayana, Tulsidas ji compiled. That Vyasadev came. Hey, that, you know, Valmiki Muni came. And he was bound to compile this Ramayana in a very village language, Maithili Vasa. Village language. Why, Maharaj? He is knowing Sanskrit. He could write, yes. Previously, he started writing in Sanskrit. Follow? I've been there, the birthplace of Tulsidas ji, Shoro, Shukar Khetro, when Varahadev disappeared that place, that's Shukar Khetro. Shoro, Shoro, one place, Shukar Khetro. Not Suttal, not Suktal. Suktal is the place where Sukhdev Goswami speak Bhagavatam. Suktal, it is Shoro, Shukar Khetro. Shukar Khetro it is, there. I've been there many times. And after that, actually, Tulsidas ji started staying in Ayodhya. Many long history, I don't like to speak. After that, in Chitrakoot also, one place where Ramchandra when was in exile, he was there also, Chitrakoot. Chitrakoot, very nice place. UP and MP border. If you go through train from Mathura, some train going to that place. Follow? Chitrakoot, very nice place. They actually compiled this Ramayana. But first, Tulsidas ji started writing Ramayana in Sanskrit in Varanasi, Benaras, Varanasi Khetra. First started. But as a man is writing Ramayana, Bandana, everything, every day Tulsidas ji Maharaj sleeping, morning time when open is all back end, nothing is there. I wrote 3-4 pages yesterday, nothing there, back end. Very astounded. How possible? Again writing. Next day when sleeping, when get up and find that pages, all back end. Oh my God, how possible? Then he started fasting in front of Vishwanath. Oh Vishwanath, what is the problem? I write so many pages every day. I write so many pages every day and find all pages back end. What is your arrangement? Vishwanath came in dream. It is my arrangement. Why? It is my... Vishwanath speaking. Why? Because I want to see Ramayana in Maithili Vasa, in village language, so that all common people can read. Already Sanskrit Ramayana is there. Valmiki Ramayana. So you will have to write in Maithili language. Very. Maithili Vasha, very nice. Then he took instruction from Vishwanath and started writing. Sometime writing Sanskrit sloka, sometime writing Sanskrit, but all in details. Like Vrindavan Das Thakur Maharaj, sometime Chaitanya, sometimes Sanskrit sloka, all in Bengali paya. This is right. There you keep, if you go through this Tulsidas Ramayana, you can get more and more taste. You can go through Valmiki Ramayana, but if you go through Tulsidas Ramayana, you can get more sweetness. So sweetness, so nice. Follow, you see. There you can find all different tattva, nice tattva of Sita Devi, Ramchandra, very nice. Anyway, time cannot permit. Today I am going to stop my small speech here, and I beg for kipa from Jannamata Thakurani and from Sita Devi, Ramchandra Sakti, and from Nityananda Sakti, Jannamata Thakurani. That's all. Vancha Kalpatrava Sikibasanda Bhavacha Patitanang Pavana Bhavishna Bhyo Namo Nama. So, any question? No question. I already give you question. What else? What question? Tulsidas Ramayana, actually it is the Maithili Vasa. I cannot remember all, but some one or two. But actually, usually, I read this Ramayana long before. Sri Ramachandra Kipalu Bhajamana. This slogan, I can sing someday, not here, in front of. Very nice.